The first thing you need to do is to make sure your gown is the right size. So try it on as soon as you get it. There are no male and female gowns. There's just one gown for everybody. And the bottom of the bell sleeves should fall between your elbow and the palm of your hand. The bottom of the gown should fall below the knee and above your ankles. If your gown is not the right size, check with your Herf Jones representative right away. This is also the perfect time to practice putting on your hood. Simply place the hood around your neck and shoulders so that it hangs down your back with the velvet portion displayed. Then fasten the cord on the front of the hood to your shirt, dress, or gown to keep it off your neck. You can do this by wrapping it around a shirt or blouse button, or by using a safety pin to attach it to your clothing. The bottom part of the hood has a bit of a tail or dangler. Some people make the mistake of turning this inside out. If your hood looks like this, with a tube of fabric that's not sewn on to anything, then it's inside out. So just turn it around the other way so it looks like this. Also, if your regalia includes a stole or cord, the stole goes on first and the cord on top of that, and then the hood goes on last. To remove any wrinkles, simply use a cool iron or steamer, or hang it in your bathroom while you take a hot shower. Do not wash or dry clean your gown, as it will ruin the fabric. To know which side of your cap faces forward, just look inside for the word front. The tassel attaches to the button on the top of the cap or tam. Mortarboard caps should be flat and level to the floor. The crown for caps and tams should be about an inch above your eyebrows. For doctorate degrees, your tassel is worn on the left side of your cap near the temple before, during, and after graduating. It's not moved from the right to the left side. Well, that's it. Now, come graduation day, you can look your best for the crowd as well as the cameras. Congratulations!